Hey, what's up? John Sonmez here from SimpleProgrammer.com. Tired of pushy recruiters sending you LinkedIn requests for jobs you have no interest in? Tired of blasting out resumes into the dark? If so, you should check out Hired.com. Hired.com flips job searching on its head by having top employers like Facebook come to you after you fill out one simple application. You also get your own job coach to help you on your next job search. If you haven't checked it out, I highly recommend you at least fill out the application. Just go to Hired.com/simpleprogrammer, and when you get hired with Hired, you'll get double the normal sign-on bonus for using that link. And today we are going to be talking about, should I teach in order to learn? So I got this question, should I teach in order to learn? And this question is from Mark, and he says, hello John, I'm interested in programming. I recently started with Python. I know the best way to learn is to teach. Good, you are correct. It's the best way to understand something. Should I teach others through YouTube or blog right now in the beginning? I only know basic things, or should I wait and start with teaching after my first junior job, for example? Thanks. So I actually did an interview with a guy that, I think it was Tabian. I'm trying to remember, he just told me his pronunciation of his name. But you can check out the interview here. It should be published by the time that you're watching this video. And it's interesting. He actually did this. He actually just started learning programming, okay? And he is watching this YouTube channel, and he said, you know what? John says make a blog and make a YouTube channel, and so I'm gonna do that, even though I'm just learning. And he did. And in that interview, he talks about how he's had success, and he's had some big clients making some serious money that have come to him from his YouTube channel. I think at the time that I recorded the video, he had like 4,000 or 5,000 subscribers. And he basically was honest, and he's like, I'm making these tutorials, I'm learning this stuff myself, right? And he blogged about it, and it really benefited him. So, and it didn't just benefit him from getting clients and getting jobs. He got a job as well, and he actually quit his job to do this full time. How cool is that? So, I mean, he's actually gone from someone who had no software development experience to teaching himself software development and teaching other people while he's teaching it, right? To that causing him to get him a job within a year, to him actually walking away and turning away from a promotion to be a Java developer at that job, to going full-time teaching other people how to program on YouTube with like 2 years experience. Now, some of you say, oh, well, he can't do that. No, he can do that. He can do whatever the fuck he wants to do, okay? And that's the thing. It's like, you don't get to say what someone else can and can't do, or they're qualified to do something. And so, that's my message to you. So, yes, not only did he do that, I'll say this before I get into that, which is that he learned a lot. He learned really fast because he did that. He learned faster than most developers would. In the 2 years time frame that's passed, I'm sure that he has become way more competent. And part of it is because he posted these videos on YouTube, and I didn't look at some of the comments on them, but I'm sure he got nasty comments. I'm sure people emailed him and said, you know what? Your Android tutorial is stupid, dude. Like, you don't even know you should be using this framework or this thing, or you should have written your code this way. And he probably learned from that, right? Because he got feedback, because he got, well, not that all feedback is valuable, but he got valuable feedback. He was able to iterate on what he was doing and learn from that. So there's a huge advantage to teaching, to experimenting, to failing out in the open. And so I highly encourage you. I've done plenty of videos telling young bloggers or new developers to start a blog and start a YouTube channel. In fact, check out my course. I've got a free course on how to create a blog to boost your career, which is really just a course on blogging. And that's gonna help you starting out. But all the time I get emails from students in that course, and they say, oh, I'm a beginner, I'm just starting out. Can I teach? Yes. Teach. Even if you're wrong about some stuff, like you're so right when you say that teaching is the best way to learn. So do it. And so what? You know, I mean, my first YouTube videos on this channel, if you go back, they sucked really bad. Like my first blog post sucked. A lot of times I didn't even know what I was talking about to some degree. You could say that, right? I've revised my viewpoints. I've revised my abilities as a programmer when I blogged about programming stuff when I was first writing code, but I still taught it out in the open. I still did that. And I didn't teach it as if I've have 15 years experience and I know all this stuff. I taught it as, look, this is my journey and I'm learning this stuff and here's what I have and this is what I think. Like, if this is either right or tell me if it's wrong. But it's one of those. It's either right or if it's not, then you tell me that it's wrong. But otherwise, I'm going to go with it's right, right? And that's I think that's a better way to live your life. And you can create a lot of value for other people by doing that. So go out there. If you're learning, yes, teach. Go for it. Who cares if people think you're an idiot? You're gonna learn, you're gonna adapt, you're gonna get better. Your old stuff people won't even remember. It's not gonna stick with you. And you're gonna benefit some people along the way. You're gonna benefit yourself by, like you said, the best way to learn is to teach. And when I say that, I'll clarify that a little bit further, which is to say that the best way to gain deep understanding is to teach. When you teach something to someone else, you gain a much deeper understanding than any other way to gain understanding. And it'll evolve with you. So go ahead, start the blog, start the YouTube channel, and let me know when you do. I wish you the best success. All right, if you like this video, click that subscribe button below and click that bell to make sure you don't miss any videos when they come out. I'll talk to you next time. Take care.